Good morning, everyone. Thank you for watching this video abstract about our paper, GNSS Interference Mitigation, a Measurement and Position Domain Assessment. My name is Daniele Borio, and with my colleague Ciro Gioia, we work for the European Commission Joint Research Centre. As you may know, jamming and radio frequency interference are becoming more and more relevant for many GNSS applications. Indeed, there has been a growing number of interference and jamming events all around the world, as reported, for example, by the Strike3 project that deployed several monitoring stations in 23 countries and recorded, over 3 years of operation, more than 450,000 jamming and interference events. Given the impact of such interfering events, it is necessary to rethink receiver design, including interference mitigation capabilities. Several work has shown that interference mitigation can be effective in improving the receiver performance and have analyzed as principal metric the C over N zero, which however does not tell you the full stories. Indeed, here on the left part of the slides, you can see a clear example where time domain interference mitigation can improve receiving performance in terms of C over N zero. But this picture doesn't tell the full story. It's not possible to tell if biases, distortion, or loss of efficiency are introduced by interference mitigation. Thus, the goal of this paper is to assess interference mitigation from a slightly different perspective, considering measurement and position domains. The paper considers 5 popular interference mitigation techniques, including time domain pulse blanking, time domain complex signum, frequency domain pulse blanking, and frequency domain complex signum. These 4 techniques are part of what is called robust interference mitigation and are built based on principles from robust statistics. We have also considered the adaptive notch filter, which is a popular technique which tracks the jammer instantaneous frequency and tries to remove the related component, jamming component, from the input samples. For the analysis, we prepared a dedicated experimental setup that included a shielding box that was used to contain a jammer that was used as interference source. The output of the shielding box was connected to a variable attenuator that was used to simulate different jamming power levels. Finally, the jamming signal was combined with clean GNSS signal collected from a rooftop antenna. The signal contaminated by jamming were finally recorded on disk using a software-defined radio platform, a USRP. In this way, it was possible to reprocess the signals collected using different interference mitigation techniques. With this setup, we were able to analyze several different power levels and several GNSS modulations, including BPSK and BOK. In particular, we considered both the GPSL1 CA signal, the Galileo I1C modulation, and the wideband FIP signal. In this slide, you can see some of the results that are presented in details in the paper. In particular, we show that RIM techniques do not introduce biases on the pseudoranges and on the position solution. On the contrary, the adaptive notch filter introduces modulation-dependent biases, meaning that the BOK and the BPSK signals will be affected differently by this type of interference mitigation technique. Moreover, the delay introduced by the filter is a function of the filter parameters. Fortunately, the biases introduced by the adaptive notch filter are common to all the pseudorange and are absorbed in the final position solution by the clock bias term. When the adaptive notch filter is used for processing the wideband GNSS modulation, lower biases are observed as compared to the other signals. Thank you very much for watching this video abstract. You will find all the details and the experimental results in our paper that is available online at the web address reported here. The paper is open access, so feel free to look at it, download it, and if you have any questions, feel free to contact us, me and Ciro Gioia, at the email addresses reported here. Thank you again. Bye bye.